So this is a beautiful song, beautiful prayer by Lochan Das Thakur, and he is glorifying the two merciful incarnation of Lord Nityananda and Gaur Chandra. The two lords, Nitai Gaur Chandra, are very merciful. They are the essence of incarnation, of all incarnation. The specific significance of this incarnation, that they introduce the process of chanting and dancing, that is simply joyful. My dear brother, I request you, just worship Lord Chaitanya Nityananda with firm conviction and faith. If one wants to be Krishna conscious by this process, one has to give up his engagement in sense gratification. One simply has to chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Hari Hari, without any motive. My dear brother, just try and examine this within this three world. There is no one like Lord Chaitanya and Lord Nityananda. Their merciful qualities are so great that upon hearing them, even birds and beasts and cry stones melt. But Lord Sundas Thakur regrets that I am entrapped by the sense gratification. I have no attraction for the lotus feet of Lord Chaitanya and Nityananda. Then Yamaraja, the superintendent of death, is punishing me for not allowing me to be attracted by this movement. One significant point he is making here is, see, that he is addressing everyone as brothers. You also know how you use the word universal brotherhood. So you can, where is it coming from? You can see from here, brother. The point what he is making is, the birds and the beasts, when they hear this sound, stones melt. Then you can ask a question, why is it our heart is not melting? Is it not? So, it's a point for all of us to deliberate that why this is not happening, why is there is so much of difficulty in making progress in Krishna consciousness. So this is for the reason I was just coming on the way. Can I have a little attention, please? When I was coming on the way, I saw a very new car, and two husband and wife, they were driving, and there was a bulldog sitting at the back. So the dog was peeping out this way, that way. I just passed. For a moment, I was thinking, this dog doesn't know what is going in which car. But whereas the father, that the people who are sitting, husband and wife, know about the car. So if you put in real life, are we also thinking like that? Are we not sitting in a beautiful car here? But what is the purpose? So if you don't know the purpose, you are sitting in the car, we are just like that bulldog. So this is why Krishna is speaking about that human life is most important. So if we do not think that this life what we have got is important, then we can think of that dog's life. So today is a beautiful day, very auspicious day, where Lord Krishna has offered so many types of flower. If you also think, I am also one flower, and you can offer yourself, what do you think? It's a good idea? The purpose of a flower is for beautification. Or it shows some expression of joy. Greetings. So, Pushya Abhishek, today we are going to do. So we can also think that we are one among that Abhishek. A tree, so many flowers are there. But when they fall down, they fall at the foot of the tree. So who is the foot for our entire Brahmanda? Is Supreme Personality of Godhead. So we have come from that place, we have to go back there. We are part and parcel of Krishna. somehow we fell down, we are floating, and somewhere by chance of Guru Krishna's mercy, we have come. So this Parama Karuna, Lord Chaitanya's mission is that pick up everybody and bring them to the lotus feet of Lord. Srila Prabhupada was talking about once he was giving a class, he said Krishna conscious is all about taking responsibility, accountability, and also cooperating with Krishna is Krishna consciousness. So what is the use of we becoming Krishna consciousness? We don't want to cooperate with his teachings. Very significant point Srila Prabhupada is making is we have to cooperate. What is this cooperation? Jivatma with Paramatma, it has to cooperate. So this is a lifelong mission. But that lifelong mission comes only when a pure devotee puts some glance on one of us. Koi bhagyavan jiva. That means he gets that moment it starts. So when we are progressing in this, as we have to gradually remove the luggage which was there, the material luggage, what? Then we have to fill up with spiritual luggage. So unloading and loading has to be there. So this is a journey. This journey, you have to know what kind of things you have to put in the bag and what kind of things you should avoid. So all of us have a baggage. So the baggage, we don't know what to put out, what to bring in. That's where the Shastra come in. That's where the association matters a lot. Today, greatest mercy that given by Lord Chaitanya is the association of devotees who are realized. We can't take anybody's association just like that. We have to associate with the right kind of people. Prabhupada explains two aspects. Association of Bhagavata. Association of more than Bhagavata is that Bhagavata person is also more important than the Bhagavata thesis. Sometimes we may read Bhagavatam, we may not understand. But the person Bhagavatam is more important because he has realized it. So this cooperation movement is between Jivatma and Paramatma. How will that happen? This cooperation can happen that in between when Guru and Krishna come between. So Guru facilitates this union. So every individual jiva has to think this. Family life is a marriage. Marriage means responsibility. Marriage means cooperation. Marriage means accountability, is it not? In the same way, Krishna conscious is that kind of thing where we get married to Krishna's conscious principles. We have to abide by what instructions he is giving. And not just that, we have to walk through it. So every acharya who is speaking about, they are trying to bring us more closer and closer to Krishna. So taking this one particular chapter of the seventh canto, Prahlad Maharaj, where you can see, even Yudhishthira Maharaj is asking this question. Are Baba, what is Grihastha life? How are we supposed to be? So what is that sometimes we come across, oh, I am not able to progress in Krishna consciousness. Is it superficial talking or it is a reality? If it is a reality, please open the seventh canto chapter. You will know what it is, life is. So if you are doing a lip service, you cannot make progress. There should be sincerity, there should be commitment, then the progress starts. Such an exalted Vaishnava is Yudhishthira Maharaj. Why is he asking this question to Narada Muni? Because he knows the world, how it's going to come forward. It is not that Krishna will pick up the best candidate for his teachings. No, he just picked up ordinary person, Arjuna, he's a Kshatriya. So Krishna can pick any one of us. So in that process, are you ready? He's going to pick you up. Are you ready? That is important. Are you going to lift your hand?
So this is what matters. Your hand cannot go up because there is difficulty in this heart. The choice is still not the right choice. Am I right? When you make the right choice, then you have bliss. If you don't make the right choice, what happens? So, this is the perfect list. I will just share with you the seven slokas from the Bhagavatam, where Srila Prabhupada explained in the purport exactly what we are supposed to do, why we can't make progress. But if you apply it, why we can. That's what it's showing here. So Shastra is not there to just read and understand. Shastra is there to walk. If you can't do it, find a person who walks through that. So every festival for us, celebration, is only to make us go nearer Krishna. Bind us more and more with that kind of realization. The more you participate in the festival, the more you act in Krishna consciousness, in cooperation, then there is progress. Srila Prabhupada was talking, we are not meant for masses, we are meant for classes. He made this statement. He said, we are for class. So what is that class? Is this, that the people have to show, you know, it is when you go, let's say some kind of a people who are all around here, they may have big programs, a lot of people are there. But in our ISKCON, we have people very limited number. Why is that? Because we have regulations. We have commitments of that which is not going to encourage in materialism. So 33 crore devatas are there to fulfill your material desire. But Krishna is there to fulfill our spiritual desire. But unless we know what is spirituality, I'm coming nearby, it is very difficult to make progress. That's why here Parama Karuna Duijana, Lord Chaitanya is talking about when Jagai and Madai can become, they became a parampara, I think in the 37th generation they came. They continued. They became acharyas. So if you look at them and look at us, oh, we have a chance. Is it not? We can look in that terms. But how can we have that chance? Because they surrendered to Lord Chaitanya and Nityananda. So if at all we have not made progress, that means it's a reciprocation. What is the amount of surrender level we are going? And that level we are getting back. So the business of Krishna consciousness is very serious. It's a strong bondage. It's a commitment, lifelong, birth after birth. So we will just read this, share this pastime where instructions of Narada Muni to Yudhishthir Maharaj. This is Canto 7, Chapter 14, Text 1. The prelude to this is the ideal family life. This chapter describes the occupational duty of a householder according to the time, the country, and the performer. When Yudhishthir Maharaj became very much inquisitive about the occupational duties of a householder, for a householder, Narada Muni advised him that a grihastha's first duty is to fully depend on Krishna, Vasudeva, and try to satisfy him in all respects by executing one's prescribed devotional service. This devotional service will depend on instructions of authorities and the association of devotees who are actually engaged in devotional service. The beginning of devotional service is shravanam, or hearing. One must hear from the mouth of a realized soul. In this way, grihastha's attraction to the wife and children will gradually be reduced. Now you may all question me, what's wrong with this person? He is talking about, I have my wife, I have kids. my parents. So, if you think your children are important, your parents are important, why can't Krishna think like that? I'm asking you. Why can't a spiritual master think of that? Just like when youth can think, why he cannot think? So from this you can understand that, yes, Krishna has to write to think about me also. Because I don't know who is my father and mother. But Krishna knows he is my son. So if we think we are lost people, but Krishna is there to protect us. So he is sitting as Paramatma, sitting in the heart. He is coming through, he is sending his representative, and he is choosing the right people to speak. He has the right audience. He creates an atmosphere. And that one atmosphere is ISKCON. You can find Srila Prabhupada coming here. He is telling you all belong to Krishna. So what is the difficulty? If you think your children are important, for your father, you are important. Time and again, I'm pressing this. You are important to Krishna. Your children, they may not be that important as much as you think. Because matter of time, you know, everybody flies off. At that time, when they start refusing, when they stop cooperating with you, then you will say, what is this? My own children not cooperating. My own parents not cooperating. And I also didn't cooperate with my parents. It's very simple. When there is no cooperation, there is a break. So if this break, if you can stop this break, and that's possible only by Guru and Krishna's mercy. So if Krishna is coming and many people are talking about the Bhagavatam more and more, if we are hearing, don't feel think what is the same thing I'm hearing. Because you don't know. Recently, we have, many of us got a chance to associate with wonderful devotee Radha Gopinath Prabhu. We went to a place that, where is that? Devarayan Durga. We were a few of us, 10, 15 people. And I was a little bit looking at many devotees with their mobiles. Most of them were telling, hey, mobile network is not working. Network not working. Every one of us thinking network not working. If network doesn't work, then Krishna consciousness will work. That's why we could hear Radha Gopinath Prabhu so attentively, and we could get the cream of the cream. And you believe it or not, every one of us enjoyed. It was nice prasadam, it was nice kirtan. Everything was perfect. What if the whole audience were there? So it is necessary to qualify. You require. Probably Krishna chose these 15 people now. Maybe he will choose more and more. Because it is the qualification which matters for you to associate. In general, there is one aspect. But as you make progress in Krishna consciousness, maybe from the Bhagavad Gita, you come to the Bhagavatam. So there was always a class of people. So every time when these things happen, please keep yourself in the front. Don't think it's for her, it's for him, nothing like that. When you come here, we have to forget our body. Earlier, I used to say, leave your slippers. Sometimes you have to leave your body also outside. Come with your mind. Come with your intelligence. Because ultimately, from one body to another body, only that goes. Is it not? Only the sukshma sharira goes. So think that jada sharira, leave it there and come inside. This is Vaikuntha. In Vaikuntha, you cannot go with sthula sharira. It's not possible. So the qualification is, we leave it there and come back and again go back. But what vasanas you carry from here there, that matters a lot. Don't bring that here. You take this from here to there, not from there to here. You come unloaded, you load here and go. You get this point. So Krishna conscious process is nothing but Krishna only, nothing else. The more you think about Krishna, the more you hear his pastimes, the more you talk about him, the more you get instruction from him, will bind you to him, will qualify you to go back to Krishna. So this is the assurance given. So when you come here, if you do not think about all this, if you are thinking something else, what a great waste. So he chose, Narada Muni is choosing. Yudhishthira Maharaj is asking the right question. What is that Prabhupada said, perfect questions? Why we can't understand? Because we are insensitive to these things. We are taking up things. You know, we become complacent. Oh, I'm chanting my rounds. I'm reading. But how much is going inside? How much is it coming out? Palena parichayate. That means to say, when your actions start changing, people will see. Oh, this devotee, what, how he was, how he is now. Why are we aspiring to go with Radha Gopinath Prabhu? Why is that? Because he has more Krishna than what we have. He has more realization what we have. That's how you can go on and on from previous acharyas. We can know. So this crave for association of pure devotees, or great devotees, or exalted devotees, or devotees who are better than us, it should be the constant thinking for us. Don't think it, the life is very casual. Yeah, you'll be casual, you'll be there only. The stones are here, so many things are there, they'll be remaining like that only. Because they have no life. But we, conscious about those things, if we do not inject that inside, then it's very difficult to make progress in Krishna consciousness.
As far as maintenance of his family, a Grihastha, while earning what he requires for his living, must be very conscious and must not undergo extraordinary endeavor simply to accumulate money and unnecessary increase in material comforts. So Madhis Maharaj Yudhishthir inquired from Narada Muni, "Oh my lord, O great sage, kindly explain to me how we are staying at home without knowledge, the goal of life, may also easily attain liberation according to the instruction of Vedas." So in the previous chapter, the great sage Narada has explained how a brahmachari, vanaprastha and sannyasi should act. He first explained the dealings of a brahmachari, vanaprastha and sannyasi, because these ashramas or status of life are extremely important for fulfillment of goal of life. One should note that the brahmachari ashram, vanaprastha ashram and sannyasi ashram, there is no scope for sex life, whereas sex is allowed in grihastha life under regulation. Narada Muni therefore first described brahmacharya, vanaprastha and sannyasa because he wanted to stress that sex is not all necessary, although one who is absolutely required allowed to enter into grihastha's family. Text 2. So Narada Muni is speaking here is, "My dear king, those who stay at home as householders must act to earn their livelihood, and instead of trying to enjoy the results of their work for themselves, they should offer the results to Krishna, Vasudeva. How to satisfy Vasudeva in this life can be perfectly understood through the association of great devotees of Lord. The format of grihastha life should be a dedication to the Supreme Personality of Godhead. In Bhagavad Gita, it is said that one who is unattached to the fruits of work, who works as he is obligated, is in renounced order of life. Said he is true mystic, not he who lights no fire and performs no work. Whether one acts as a brahmachari, grihastha, vanaprastha, sannyasi, he must act only for satisfaction of Supreme Personality of Godhead, Vasudeva Krishna. This should be the principles of everyone's life." What an important point he is making here is, he says he must act only for satisfaction of Supreme Personality of Godhead. Now we can analyze, what are we doing? If every act of ours is satisfying Krishna, you are a pure devotee. But if you are trying to do, that means you are in the process. But if you don't do, and if you are thinking, why I am not make progress, it's a stupid thing to think about. You are not making progress because you don't want to make progress. So the amount of the weight you've got, how can you travel light?
So the more number of karmas, relationship is there, the more difficult for us to become Krishna's relative. The more we are entangled in materialism, it's very difficult to take up spiritualism. But there is a transition which happens from materialism to spiritualism. That is the sadhana. That is the association. That's what matters for all of us. If out of 10 years, 20 years, 30 years, whatever little progress you have made, that is because of Krishna's mercy and your little endeavor. But that endeavor has to become stronger and stronger for then only we can go back to Krishna. If I'm going to ask all of you, how many of you want to go back to Vaikuntha? What will happen now? Is there anybody who will not lift the hand? Huh? No, I'm not going to ask. So the point is, why lip service? Why not work towards that? So this is the progress. Srila Prabhupada's mission is meant for class, not for the mass. If you're coming here as a mass, you will be a mass only. You know, other word of mass is substance. That's all, no progress. So you have a determined effort to make this progress. And there are wonderful examples in this world, in this ISKCON world, where they have made such a transition. Nobody has become a beggar. If a devotee of very high level, coming from IIT, if he joined ISKCON movement, don't be perplexed. He has done it because of his intelligence, not his mooda. Sometimes we think, hey, is he IIT in Fali, come and join here. Even devotees speak like this. Because it's a poor fund of understanding. That person is very, oh, Mahatma, very difficult. You should be thinking, oh my God, what a renunciation. He could have earned lakhs of rupees, but he's coming and he is staying in the temple with a few crores, dhotis. By these things only our heart can change. Our heart is very strong. What is that? Very hard to melt. When you see a person who has surrendered, when you see his commitment, then there is a little commitment. Okay, let me also do something. Okay, he's a brahmachari. Let me get him a pair of dress. So you're making progress. Let me do something. I'm not able to commit like him. At least let me serve him. This is Krishna conscious. So every one of us can make progress that way. But if you think, oh my God, he is IIT, he wasted his life. But unfortunately, this is not here. This is not true. A Brahmana is that intelligent person. He does only quality of worshipping Krishna all the time. So if today, if devotees have joined the temple, that means they've understood the purpose of life is only to serve Krishna. Nothing else. So we have to think, okay, he is going to serve, let me support him. So this is the cooperation. This is what Prabhupada wanted. Brahmana, Kshatriya, Vanaprastha, and all of them bind together is Grihastha. These three people are freelancers. They are only one thing, only one, no Krishna, nothing else. But this Vanaprastha is the danger where we get so many things in our life, and all the three people required to get him out of this. So today, if you are in Grihastha ashram, get wedded to these three people, Brahmachari, Vanaprastha, and Grihastha, and Sannyasi, who can get you out of this. And this moment, you will find all those. So a Grihastha ashrama is andukupam. It can take you millions of life backwards. If not properly executed, or if you are not properly situated, or if you are not properly associated with the proper devotees. So Grihastha ashrama is, that's what exemption is. When we cannot sustain our brahmacharya, you have a window where Grihastha ashrama, under rules and regulation, you make progress. This is what Narada Muni is explaining to Yudhishthira Maharaj. Continuing, the science of satisfying the Supreme Lord can be learned, described here, Sakshat Upasila Mahamuni. The word Mahamunim refers to a great saintly persons of devotees. Saintly persons are generally known as Munis, the philosopher concerned with transcendental subject matter. And Mahamuni refers to those who have not only thoroughly studied the goal of life, but who are actually engaged in satisfying the personality of Godhead Vasudeva. These persons are known as devotees. Unless one associated with devotees, one cannot learn the science of Vasudeva Parayana and dedicating one's life to Vasudeva, Krishna, Supreme Personality of Godhead. So here, the point Srila Prabhupada is making, that one devotee who comes here as a sannyasi, as a preacher, you should grab the mercy. Oh, you be complacent, it's not going to happen. Sometimes neighbors also don't come to the temple. They don't know that who is coming here. So that moment, that little association of pure devotees or exalted devotees can push you so much higher you don't even know. Unknowingly these things happen. So when this mantra upasaka, Srila Prabhupada is explaining that person who always carries Krishna, and when he gives you association, you should be in the receiving mood, not that, okay, I will go sometime, and if I am free, I am going. It's very rare. It is very rare for such association, what you get. The more you serve these devotees, the more faster you make progress. The student associated with teacher, he gets better marks. Because he is grabbing the intelligence from Guru. So the same thing when Vaishnavas, exalted devotees are there, don't hesitate. Keep all the things by the side and come. So this is the most important secret of Krishna consciousness. The eagerness, the lavlyam, what you have for the desire to hear, the desire to make progress in Krishna consciousness is that lavlyam. That should be there for all of us. Continuing here, you can know that I'm not asking you to get out of those responsible service, that is necessary. But along with that, what Prabhupada explains, you will know what it is. He also recommends 8 hours of working. It is not that we leave everything and come. So, the third and the fourth sloka, very important. A grihastha must associate again and again with saintly persons. He didn't say brahmachari, he didn't say vanaprastha. He's talking about grihastha, because ideal life. He must hear the nectar of activities of the Supreme Lord. His incarnation, as these activities are described in Srimad Bhagavatam and other Puranas. Thus, one should gradually become detached from affection. Kindly hear carefully. Thus, one should gradually become detached from affection of his wife and children, exactly like a man awaking from a dream. I am not saying this. Prabhupada is telling that. I mean, Bhagavatam is speaking that, or Narada Muni is telling that. So if you accept Narada Muni, then don't go home and divorce. It's not that. The consciousness, what it matters. This life is not ultimate with them. Our ultimate life is with Krishna, with Guru. They're all there. We are journeying. Just like Prabhupada said, train is going. Yeah, they're all there. But each one will get down and go, even if you don't want to. How many, after 23 years, let us say your daughter is there, will you keep her in your house? Will you not go and search for a nice groom? After getting her married, no, you stay with me. Who will say that? So it's a natural process. It's a natural process of including and excluding. As long as one has to be dependent, we have to protect them. But when they become independent, when they can stand on their own leg, what's your problem? Because you yourself are going to be shaky after 60 years or 50 years. Nowadays, after 50, people cannot sit down. So what's happening? That means your body is wearing out. So will they come and protect you? No. If they are Krishna consciousness, yes, you have a hope. What if not? So you are not going to lose. So, a Grihastha ashram, he is talking about here. Yes, wife is there, children is there, everybody is there. But they are also children of Krishna. Don't worry, Krishna will protect them also. The moment you are born, what did you think of? You never thought you will be here. That means somebody protected you. Why you can't take the same principles and think, yes, Krishna will protect me. So many examples are there. Bhrigari, Narada Muni went and protected him. So there will be some avadhuta coming here. Yes, going to protect. So it is that what you are going to hear. So the dream of this illusion, it could be a relative reality, but you'll go away. So if your goal of life is fixed in one Grihastha ashrama, this is our problem. What is goal of life is very, very difficult. Because every time this goalpost keeps changing. What do you think? This goal is very illusion. Every time the goal keeps changing. Yeah? So, devotee is having a nice smile. I don't know what for. Okay, you can ask them. So that is the point is, the goal of life in Vanaprastha is the most, Grihastha ashrama is the difficult thing, but whereas the other three are completely fixed. That is why barambar you have to keep listening. The same thing, we go on hearing and hearing, exalted Vaishnavas. So the purpose says, Krishna conscious movement has been established to give Grihasthas all over the world an opportunity to hear Srimad Bhagavatam and Bhagavad Gita specifically. Who is telling this? Bhakti Vedanta Swami Prabhupada. So what happens in this temple? An opportunity is given for opportunity is created. It is not mercy. How many of you come for Bhagavatam class right in time? Only few hands lefted. So now you have to understand why is that you are coming. You may have too many things in your mind. So many programs. But here Prabhupada says, our movement is meant for hearing and chanting. So he goes further. The process of describing in many ways is one hearing Srinvatam Swakat Krishna. Everyone, especially Grihasthas who are mudadhi, ignorant about goal of life, should be given an opportunity to hear about Krishna. Simply by hearing and attending lectures in different centers of Krishna conscious movement, where topics of Krishna from Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam are discussed, they will be purified of their sinful inclination for constant indulgence. So now, the point is, if you are not going to do this, will you make progress? If you don't come, okay, I'll sit at home. I'll do everything. But he doesn't say that. He says, come here at the association of devotees and make progress. So if an extraordinary devotee, exalted devotee comes, at a Sunday is an opportunity for you to come and hear, make full use of it. Don't make part. No part. Full. Try your best. It can happen. See, nothing will happen in this world without Lord's mercy. You all agree. But if you decide to do something for Krishna, why he will not be completed? Why he will not sanction it? You tell me. You may have 101 reasons. But those reasons will just go like that because just yesterday I was going. Suddenly traffic became so slow, it was like almost walking. What happened? Later on I go home and see that Amit Shah has come to Bangalore. Amit Shah has come to Bangalore somewhere there, but traffic is jamming here. See the effect of an ordinary material so-called person can stop. If Krishna were to be there, what will happen? So if you want to serve Krishna, all those difficulties will just vanish. You only desire. I want to go to the temple. I want to go and hear. That's it. The more you think about this, the Krishna will make everything go like that. You have to only desire. So the desire factor will happen only with constant endeavor. Every day you have to dream. Continue dreaming. So another specific description, it is not because one who has finished Bhagavad Gita, he should go on hearing again and again. One should, Srila Prabhupada says, that one should work 8 hours at most to earn livelihood, and either in the afternoon or evening, householders should associate with devotees to hear the incarnation of Krishna and his activities, and thus be gradually liberated from clutches of Maya. There is a beautiful story in compared to this attachment to Maya. You want to listen? Bhakti Siddhantwari Thakur says, he gives in his Upakhyana. There was one very hunger beggar, a person who was very hungry, and he was there in a chowdhury on a pillar. So he was there, you know, he couldn't, no food to eat, almost he was falling and things like that. At that time, there was one gentleman, he saw this person doesn't have any money. So please, this story, connect with this. Don't miss this. The story connects with that. So then what happened? he comes, he sees that person, he says, oh, he's hungry, let me buy some popcorn or puff rice. So he goes to the shop, nearby shop, and brings the puff rice and he offers him. But unfortunately, this person has embraced one pillar like this. This pillar is there. He's embracing that. Because stomach, you know, like that. So this fellow, he says, okay, he takes. But he says, no, I can't eat. Put it in my hand. He says, no, you just unfreeze your hand. Take it, I'll give you. But he's telling, no, you give it to me. He says, this guy is either intelligent or a mooda, I don't know what it is. Then he says that, okay. And he puts that puff rice in his hand. Now the puff rice is here and he's here. Can he eat? He's trying his best. He cannot. Let's come back to the. So if materialism you have embraced so strongly, Krishna consciousness is not easy. You can't get. You have to loosen that grip there. Maya Devi ka thoda chodo, Bhagwan ko pakado. So this is what Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur is talking about. The more you loosen the grip over Maya, then you get grip over Krishna. So Grihastha Ashrama is like that. The moment you get into this wedlock, samsara, it completely changed. So it is not that it is not going to, because 99% in the world are Grihasthas, or maybe 999. But only a few are making progress in Krishna consciousness. So if you want to really go back to Godhead, these are the slokas, 5 to 6 slokas, which every day you go on through, then slowly you will identify, not that you will run away. You will identify, you will work in such a way that these things don't, you know, come in between our progress in Krishna consciousness. That's what it matters. You're a husband, fine, but you're also a devotee of Lord. So you have a purpose, fulfill it, but you have something to do. So these interactions always have to come to this mind. Oh, I am first a spirit soul. The more number of times we think, the better it is for us. Then continuing there, what Srila Prabhupada says, one who is transcendently situated, at once realizes Supreme Brahman, becomes fully joyful. Never laments nor desires to have anything. He is equally disposed towards all living beings. Text 5. While working to earn his livelihood, so much as necessary to maintain the body and soul together, one who is actually learned should live in human society, unattached to the family affairs, although externally appearing very much attracted. So now he is giving you the solution. Narada Muni, Akanda Brahmachari, he is giving Grihastha Ashrama. That means you say some previous life must have married. Where is this experience coming from? From somewhere. So we don't know his life, how many life he has taken. So the experiences of a jiva It can be from any life. When Shankaracharya was questioned, what do you know about Grihastha? You don't know anything about Grihastha life, why are you giving lecture on that? To experience that, he told his disciples, keep my body, I want to enter a woman's body and come back. And he comes and he answers. So there is a capability, they can do, they can transmigrate, do anything. Because they are empowered by the Lord. So now he is the point, what is he making is, yes, you can remain unattached to the family affairs, although externally appearing very much attached. It is not duplicity. It is a reality. You can't be indifferent in the house. Let us say, wife and children may not be Krishna consciousness. That you are rejecting them. Certainly you are wedded, you ought to follow. But that's not ultimate, that's there in the heart. Which, okay, they are there, I have to do my duty. So here what is he is telling you, make a show. This is the picture of ideal family life. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu asked Ramananda Raya about the goal of life. Ramananda Raya describes in different ways. According to the recommendation revealed scriptures, finally Sri Ramananda Raya explained that one may stay in his own position, whether as a Brahmana, Kshudra, or Sannyasi, whatever, but one must inquire about life's goal. Ato Brahma Jignasa. So this is the point what he is trying to make. Baba, goal of life, even there for a husband, even there for a wife, even there for children, even there for the parents. So you have to bring in that goal aspect. What's going to happen to you? So a person who is sincere will pick it up. A person who is not sincere, who is into the material aspect, he will go on like that, life. So the moment the three modes of material nature is there, it will take him to the next life, wherever it is. That is there. So here he is telling that you make a pretext. Yes, I am attached. This is the proper utilization of human form of life. When one misuses the gift of this human, unnecessarily indulging in animal propensity, subjects one to repeated birth, death, old age and disease. One is again punished by being forced to descend of lower species, undergo evolution to the laws of nature. Prakrite kriyamana ani gunai. Being completely under the grip of material nature, the living entity must evolve again from the lower species. So, if you every time you want to think of Krishna, think of the pillar. Pillar of Maya. The more you think of Krishna, then you will loosen your grip. See, it is a mind which is binding us. It is not the body which is binding us. It is the mind which is trying to, hey, you hold that pillar. It's not intelligent. So if you start a kind of disillusion by the Maya's activity, slowly you lose the grip and you'll come towards it. Now all of us can analyze what is our age today. And you put it up, okay, next 5 years, next 10 years, what is that I have to achieve? Yeah, there are immediate goals, temporary goals, you know, unknown goals. So many things are there. So you have to prioritize these things. What is required for me in the next 5 years? Go after it. No second thought. Provided it's in the right direction. That's what he says. You have to perform your prescribed duties probably. So what is your prescribed duty? Don't bring unprescribed duties there. The prescribed duties are there for a Grihastha ashrama very clearly. So you should go by that. When you look at something which is not unprescribed, then you get into a problem. So that's why the Bhagavatam, these things are very important for us. Where are we heading to? If you don't know the rasta, where will you go? You may crash. So this world is like that. Everybody is running, simply running. Where are you running? Don't know. They are running because of happiness. This happiness is nothing but an illusion in the desert. Yeah, you may get a temporary relief. But that temporary is very temporary. The next moment something happens. Because just like you today, now you had breakfast. After 4 hours, lunch. Then brunch. Then some snacks. It was nice with our Sri Gopinath Pran. Every time and again he used to give us something. But Krishna was there in the center. That's why you enjoyed more. What do you think? So, this is a sadhana, austerity, but you have no alternative. But alternative is there in ISKCON because we give you gulab jamuns. I don't know about this. Prabhupada clearly says, bring people, profusely make them eat. Make them chant. Make them dance. See what happens next week. I was one of them. We got attracted. Just like a dog. You just give one time bread. Peace. 10 times it will go around you. Why can't we be Krishna's dog? How many times he is giving so many things, but we don't recognize. His dog is better than us. The consciousness, it's faithful to him. The faith is the main factor. So, for a moment you can think dogs are better than us. So, sometimes animals are more grateful than human beings. Let's continue there. So a wise man, however, learned from the Shastras and Guru that we willing living entities are eternal but pure, put into trouble condition because of associating different modes of material nature. So the three modes which are there, that is the one which is disturbing us. He therefore concludes that human form of life should not endeavor for unnecessary necessities. Look at this. He doesn't say necessities. He says unnecessary. That means some things are necessary. Okay. Khana, peena, thoda, makan, little bit. What is that? What does the government say? A roti, kapda, makan. Don't ask for a car. It'll come by on its own. But should be very simple life, just maintaining the body and soul together. Certainly, one requires some means of livelihood according to one's varna and ashrama. This means livelihood is prescribed in the Shastra. One should be satisfied with this. Therefore, instead of hankering for more and more, a sincere devotee of Lord tries to invent some ways to earn his livelihood. Then when he does so, Krishna helps him. Now, Srila Prabhupada is telling, when you make this endeavor, Krishna makes his first step. Ah, he's seen me. Please go back to your own life, each one of you. Did you think of tomorrow? Never, because certain things were already there. What you have, that gives you the strength. Oh, parwani, mera paas itna paisa hai, kal ke liye chalega. This is our danger. If you think I have something with me which will protect you, it will not protect you. In the same way, this body, aaj chode kal chanting karenge, parso chanting karenge, karte jao wo chale jayega. Chanting, that body also goes. So this keeping for tomorrow, don't take out from your dictionary. As much as possible. Tomorrow never comes. This is a saying, is it not? Some people say tomorrow never comes. But it's true. Tomorrow never comes if Krishna is not there. Our next life should be with Krishna. When we go, today we are offering flowers. Think of that flower. What is that flower meant for? Fragrance. The beauty, the colors, everything is there in that. Ultimately it goes in the feet of. So if we offer, our acharya said that we offer ourselves as a fruit, as a flower. The text sikh, most important. I'll conclude after that. An intelligent man in human society should make his own program of activities very simple. If there are suggestions from his friends, kindly hear carefully. If suggestions are from his friends, children, parents, brothers, or anyone else, he should externally agree. Saying, yes, that's all right, but internally he should be determined not to create a cumbersome life in which the purpose of life will not be fulfilled. How many of you agree? How many of you have disagreed? It happens in our experience. Let's say the parents. We go and ask parents something. The parents will think whether it is useful to him and then only he'll make a purchase. Is it not? Have you not seen? Then he make a, in the same way, this is what he's talking about. So many things come, so many people in come in our life. They will tell you, do this, do that, so many things. Suddenly, let us say, Gopinath Pran, he's awarded 1 crore rupees. Haribol. Gopinath Pran life is only 1 crore. Eh? He's a great asset to ISKCON. No crores can be added there, no zeros. So, when he is awarded, what happens? All his relatives will go to him and ask, hey, you can do this, you can do that, you can do that. If he is not intelligent, they will take away that crore, he will be left with zero. Is it not? If he has no intelligence, what happens? Everybody will steal his money. Tan tan gobal. So that's what it is. In the same way, human life, this is what he is speaking about here. If they contribute to your spiritual growth, you can accept. If they don't, then you have to be making a pretext. Let it be anybody. Here, no jati bed. Here, what it's this Bhagavatam is speaking about, soul to soul, not to body body. But nevertheless, bodies are there. We have people around us. But you have a choice. How the choice is that, let us say, two brothers are there. One becomes a drunkard. The other one is intelligent. Will he become a drunkard? No, no, he is my brother. Whatever he say, I will do. No, you have a choice. Is it not? Though the choice, you start, what do you call, exercising it. The choice what you make, you become that. That is important. So if you choose to be a great devotee of Lord, nobody can disturb that. But it's your choice. I don't like Karela, but he likes Karela. It's his choice, it's my choice. But Karela by itself is something else. It's only the tongue with this one it is telling, no, it's bitter. But how come it's not bitter to him, it's bitter to me? He says this bitter is good for health, so he's eating. That means intelligent fellow. And I, no, no, because if I go to bitter to my tongue, so this is superficial. That is the real fact. So spiritual life may appear bitter, may be difficult, may be a difficult choice, but no alternative for one life. So if all of us have 50 years, 60 years, 40 years, you please put it and see next your what life is going to be. So unless you plan your life, you can't go back to Krishna just like that. It's not a chance. By chance you are here. By choice you stay here. Chance and choice, a lot of differences there. There is one chance everybody gets. But you have to choose whether I have to be here. So Krishna conscious movement is never think, by chance you go and land up in a supermarket. What happens? So much of confusion. All your money goes. So this world is like supermarket with unwanted stuff stuffed everywhere. And we don't know what to buy. And every time we bring something, after 5 years, service goes back. But human life is most important. That is why we have to make the right choice. So that is, yes, that's all right. But internally should be determined not to create cumbersome life in which the purpose of life will not be fulfilled. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. I don't know how much I am following. I am trying my best. I am also a sadhaka. Don't come and tell me, Narahari Prabhu, from here onwards I am going to have a microscope. I want to see your life. Don't do that. You will be disappointed. I am also trying. But I am just trying to share whatever be given by Acharya. And trying to sincerely see what I can also make progress in life. You are all not among the masses. You are among the class where Prabhupada wants you. If Prabhupada wants you, he has some plan for you. So your cooperation with Prabhupada instructions, Prabhupada society, This is a wonderful society. It's growing up. We were small, now it's become big. So that means we have a bigger audience going to come more and more. So if you don't, you're already a recipient. Now you should become, so that you complement others by this education of Krishna Conscious program through various programs, whatever you do. Recently I saw an article coming in the one of the ISKCON website where virtual farm has started a skill development program. They may have a hidden agenda. So Vedanta Group, it's a $1 billion company, they have tied up with our ISKCON. That means ISKCON is now doing some hidden agenda also. Earlier what Prabhupada said, and now what we are doing is, we are finding different ways of means of touching the hearts of the people. Maybe Prabhupada would have agreed now. So the skill development program, so these people are teaching Bhagavad Gita also along with that one course they have put. So you can find various means where you can attract people through children, through the dance, through the art, through culture. So please use all your skill and attract as many people as possible. They are actual our bandhus. We are here sitting, brotherhood is talking, we are all brothers and sisters. So this is relation built with Krishna being in the center. This is not karma being in the center. In the present situation where we are, karma has brought our families together. But here in ISKCON, it is Krishna who has brought us this. So this difference you have to know. If you don't identify, it's very, very difficult to make progress in Krishna consciousness. If you don't do it voluntarily, then nature will do it. At that time, you will repent. Pray, my God, I had a chance to do it. So, a great opportunity for us that the moment we get into a realization, as we make progress, you are in the right direction. Any questions, comments? Are we in time? You should come out of that association. There is no alternative. Krishna says, Bhagavad Gita, mind is very difficult to control. So if you have to control the mind, it's only by practice, by abhyas. So you have to make a determined effort to leave that. At the same time, you have to have some people, very close friend of yours, who will bother you to come tomorrow to ISKCON. You understand? Suppose if I don't come 2 weeks, 3 weeks, somebody will call me up, why you not come? So you should have the right kind of friends, right kind of people with you, who will, even though you slip, they'll bring you back. A strong association is welcome for every one of us. If strong association is there, then even if chance we fall apart, it can. Even if you take Jada Bharat's case, previous life, he had strong association, suddenly, but somehow he came with association, came back. It can happen generations. So the moment you realize that I lost, that itself is a realization. Now, the answer to your question is there with you only. When you said that, this question is coming up, that's a very proactive thinking. So immediately you come back. No, this is the right place to come back. So create an atmosphere where you will find somewhere people will engage you in Krishna conscious service. There is no other go. Strong. Anybody can add to her? Yes. So service binds you more. He's a good manager. He knows how to bind people. So he has read Prabhupada's book. He says, come on, thoda service karo. Jai andar. Yes, what is next?
Study of Bhagavatam.
Huh?
Sometime in a day.
Yeah. Absolutely. I don't think if you are a retired person, you should only keep reading it. Understanding, nothing else. So, Bhagavatam is that ripened fruit touched by... Have anyone tasted a mango touched by a parrot? Very tasty, I have done it. But in real life, this one also, Bhagavatam, touched by a parrot, becomes very rasamalayam. So great opportunity for all of us. So my concluding part is this. What I'd like to say is, just think about how much life is left for you. Take a diary. Priorities. First priority, second priority, third, you make it, your life will become bliss. That means you have drawn your line towards Krishna. So otherwise, very difficult. It will go on tomorrow, day after tomorrow, it will go on. So make a diary, take a diary. This is, put it into three class. My life, your life, our life. You got it? My life, your life, our life. What is my life? To do with me. Your life, my better half, my family around. And our life, a whole, the world around us. So if you do not make, then your my life will go, you will be for others only. Then Brahmanda, that means you will punarjanma, go to another. So don't get deceived by this. This mind is a great enemy. That's what Krishna says, mind is a great enemy. Be careful with it. That means having an enemy inside us, where is the question of fighting? We unseen person is. We don't see our enemy, no? If you don't see what in the fire, what you will do? So for that you require intelligence. Divya Chakshu, Gnana Chakshu. That can identify. That means what is that? It identifies with the senses. The senses, what it says, take this only, don't take that. So the same mind can be doubtful to do the right things. And that can happen with your determination. That can happen with your strong association with people. Then you make progress. Hare Krishna. Bhagavatam ki jai. Yeah? Yeah. Oh, one question here. Yeah. Hmm. Hmm. I didn't understand your question. Dadami buddhi yogam tam. So once in material life we are acting on our own free will and at the same time modes of material nature. But when it comes to the spiritual aspect, when we start understanding the instructions of Krishna, then you will start acting according to Krishna. Now you take example of Krishna and Arjuna. Before that he was acting independent. He took a decision of going to the forest. But after he heard from Krishna, then he things changed. No, I will do whatever you say. So it is necessary that when you don't know what you are doing, whether correct or not, you will have to find that other person to tell you whether you are correct or not. Let us say you are a wife. You can ask your husband, am I going in the right direction? You can ask your friend, am I going in the right direction? So it is necessary that we cannot know, we may blindly be going thinking what we are correct. So if you look at the samvada between Lord Chaitanya and Ramanandra, you can easily know that every answer Lord Chaitanya had something else to say. You get it? So a jiva has a tendency to not completely be learned. So at that time, Paramatma will come and correct us. Through, it could be in any source. So it is necessary for you, Guru, Sadhu, Shastra, these are the things which will protect you to do the right thing. Guru, Sadhu, Shastra, it can be your family met. So there is definitely, you can come out of this material nature. The present life, your previous life has come under material nature. That you understand, according to karma. But why do you want to fall for the same trap this life? So now the moment you realize, you start thinking, okay, now let me go according to the Shastra. That's why Prabhupada is speaking about. Why did Narada Muni speak to Yudhishthira Maharaj, such an exalted person who knew everything? Dharma itself is, he is representing. He himself is asking question. He himself made a mistake. Is it not? So there is a tendency when you think you can do better, you can make a mistake. So the difference between, Srila Prabhupada explained, between Yudhishthira Maharaj and Arjuna, he says Arjuna is a pure devotee because he completely surrendered to Krishna, even though he was not that kind of dharmatma as Yudhishthira Maharaj. But Yudhishthira Maharaj was dharmatma, he was representing, but still he was taking decisions which was contrary to what he was doing. So the dharma, what pronunciated by Krishna, is still higher. Dharmachu Shakshat Bhagavat Praditam. So that is higher. So now you are with that association of Bhagavatam, Bhagavad Gita and association of devotees. It's very difficult to slip out. Provided you don't want to slip. That is very important. Now the very fact, maybe you are 20 years in Krishna consciousness. Can I take that? 27 years. So 20 years you are still here. That means something is attracting here. Is it not? So otherwise you would have gone off. Yes, Keshav Gaur Prabhu. Yes.
One is that your family is on the Grihastha family, all of them are following Krishna consciousness. If one family member is advancing, other family is not advancing so much. It's a kind of hindrance in the old family. That the person was advancing, and this is a male number. That's one question. Second question is,
before that I can we'll talk about this. Let me finish that. The first question is that if one of the family members is not making progress, is it our duty to stay with them or go out? See, karma bandhanat. When we are wedded, it according to the Hindu, I'm talking from the present situation, we get married irrespective of whatever they are, you are wedded to them. That's why when I said your life, my life, our life. So it is the constitutional right. The Manu Dharma says you have to protect the people who are dependent on you. Just because they are not Krishna consciousness, they cannot be let off. You cannot say they are disturbing my life. Because you are perceiving they are not coming to your expectations, you are feeling bad. But certainly Jiva is, you know, dependent on Krishna's energy. So you cannot compel somebody to do what you want. Even spiritual life and material life also. Let us assume so many students are in school. Some students come out with high marks, some will not. You can't compel why you are getting low marks, why he is getting more. No, that's the nature. You can't help. But that doesn't mean you should also get less marks, even though you know. So as a husband, it is your prime duty to provide whatever, not unnecessary necessities for the family to stay together. And in Kali Yuga, it is not prescribed to go vanaprastha anywhere. You have to stay near the temple and you can be. And you can always pray for that soul to Krishna, please make them Krishna consciousness. That's all. You make an atmosphere. There is no question of rejection. They have to stay. But children, for that matter, they get married, they go to another family. But wife, parents cannot be separated. You have to stay as long as, you know, you are there. In fact, the Shastra say, if you are going, out, make sure that the wife can be with the son or somebody else. So it's a protective nature. So it's nowhere it's said that you have to leave them just like that and go. In Kali Yuga, it's not prescribed. Second thing is, in Vrindavan, as long as you can breathe. Yes. If you can support them, you can. In 90, you can't all support yourself. What you will support her? No detachment. It's antaranga. My dear sir, this is speaking, not me. Just now I explained one sloka where it says, you can, under the pretext of being nice to them, you can be with them. That's all. Correct. Detachment cannot be superficial. Yeah, there is no harm. What is effort? Can you go inside their mind and do? You can provide them Krishna Prasadam. You can give them a nice house. You can give them a nice environment. All that you can do. But you can't enter their heart and put Krishna there. Because it's there in our heart, na? I don't say it is attachment. I say it is a duty which you have to protect your. See, you can't bring all our relatives there. Here it's talking about first wife. So that is your prime duty. For your children who are dependent on you, I will not go outside. Then the parents, these are our first families. They have to be protected, not more. Even if children are well situated, you can't go after them. You have to protect yourself. Because this life only you are there with them. Next life, where will you go? Will they take you back? No. No, today, no Shastra, whatever thiti you do, no Prasad will go to the forefathers because nobody can chant properly. The Vedic mantras, whatever your person is coming and doing, perform, all that, it can never go because he cannot do. What will go is Harinam. That's why Prabhupada said, any function happens, have holy name afterwards. We used to do Vaishnava Homa. So ultimately what transforms is your nice Vaishnava's prayers can go to your forefathers, nobody else. And this is promised by Prahalad, by Narsingdev to Prahalad Maharaj. So why do you have to worry? You don't have to. But you have to be. This life, we are wedded, we have to be together. You cannot, there is no rejection. In Vedic life, there is no divorce. In Vedic dictionary, there is no question of you're wedded, that's it. What is the other question? The second one is over? Yeah. How many of you would agree with me? I don't know. Well, quite a few are there. So, well, if you don't agree, that is your prerogative. You have your free will. Sometimes experience speaks. See, perception matters a lot. If your expectations are there so much from your people, from other people, I'm sorry, you're wrong. You can't. Only can Krishna can do think about those things. We cannot. The moment he says, I will not chant, you can't do anything. Chapter close. You can't say, no, you're not chanting, I'm going to divorce you. No, that's not possible. Because you're wedded according to the government will put you behind bars. Tu shaadi kiya hai, jaake usko samalo. You know the recent government rule that if parents, husband, wife not taking each other, government has right to take your salary and give them. So why can't Krishna do that? When government can do, they can reverse today.